We have here for you, and I know you're all dying to hear his thoughts. I think it's better here, right? Yeah, okay. All right, we're gonna stand right here.
Okay, so you said your name was
Savannah. Yeah. All right, guys, look who's here. Can you tell people? I
know
most people know who you are.
Yes, Nkosana Moyo.
Yes,
and
Dr. Nkosana Moyo, yeah.
To witness the launch of the they call the Coalition of the Independents,
yes,
right?
Yes.
For council candidates.
Yes.
The reason I'm here,
uh-huh,
firstly, is because it shows me that young people, because most of the candidates, from what I can see, are young people.
Yes.
And I think that's a good thing.
Right.
But secondly, very importantly, the concept of independence,
mm-hmm,
for me is important. Some people may recall that when I declared my candidacy, I was going to run as an independent.
Yes.
Why? Because I think independents are not constrained by a political party structure to express their views,
uh-huh,
to represent the people.
Yes.
And so the more parliament and council candidates we can have who are independent and can have an independent voice,
Yes.
I think the more regulating, if you like, our institutions will get,
okay,
by people who genuinely stand for what they believe,
yes,
as opposed to the strictures of an organization.
Yes.
So that's why I'm here, to,
yes,
celebrate those things.
So, being that when you first started, I remember you wanted to be an independent candidate. What stopped you from fighting it out and going independent as versus to all starting your own political party?
Yeah, what stopped me, in fact, we need to go further back.
Yes.
In 2000, preparing for those elections in 2000,
mm-hmm,
I wanted to stand for parliament as an independent.
Okay.
And when I talked to all my friends, all of them without exception,
yes,
said they were not going to vote for me. And they
why
say,
was that?
Because I think the concept of an independent is still not fully understood by our people.
Mm-hmm.
They don't realize that actually the trueness of voice,
yes,
of representing what is right, what you believe in,
yes,
genuinely comes through when you are independent. And I've pointed out that when you look at the politics of Africa, parties run the country for the party, not for the citizens.
Okay.
Yeah?
Yes.
And so I wanted to run for independent then, but people didn't understand it. So in fact, instead of running,
yes,
I chose, they said to me, go and join the opposition and then we'll vote for you.
Why didn't you join the opposition?
No, because I so believed in the concept of being,
yes,
having my voice unstifled.
Okay. All right.
Yeah?
But
now, as a presidential candidate, I also had to concede,
yeah,
that it's not yet a fully understood concept.
Okay.
Because people then argue that when you become a president and you've got no parliamentarians in your own party,
mm-hmm,
you won't be able to run the country, which I think is wrong.
Yeah. So the biggest thing that I'm hearing from people is that this is a direct challenge to the opposition. They feel that they're directly challenging opposition there by giving ZANU-PF power. What are your thoughts on that?
I don't think it's a challenge. I think it's complementary. I think it's an important voice of people who will not say the party says.
Yes.
the people who continue to say what they themselves believe in. They can't hide behind a party, but they can't be constrained by a party either. So both are important.
Yes.
And I hope that they don't see it as challenge or competition, but rather as complementary.
Yeah.
That's the way I would rather.
Okay. And for Ivan Mawari transitioning from being the people's voice as an activist, now he's going into council. How do you view that?
I think that's
that a good thing? Does that leave a void where activists are concerned? No.
I don't think it leaves a void. But I think it's an important transition insofar as being an activist, actually, if I may say so, is easier than taking responsibility.
Yes.
It's the same as opposing, as opposed to actually standing for something which you then have to implement.
Yes.
That is the difference.
The difference.
And so I think that represents courage in my view, to move on and say, I've done activism.
Yes.
Now I want to lead where I can actually get things done, as opposed to simply saying, I don't like this.
Yes.
So I think it's important.
Oh, great. Anything else that you want to add to the people?
I hope that the movement of independence really gets understood by the population of Zimbabwe, mm-hmm. and is supported to literally give voice to a belief system,
yes.
as opposed to being stifled by institutional, which are important, but I think can be constraining.
Yes.
So it will create a positive tension, in my opinion. So I encourage it and hope that we get an even better democracy.
Yeah.
Dynamic, full of constructive tension,
mm-hmm.
and so celebrate and please support.
Yes. One more last thing. For me as a citizen, if I support ZANU-PF or I support MDC, why should I vote for an independent candidate? Or is it a choice for me to vote my president, Chamisa, and then vote a different MP from my party, and also a councilman from the different...
Okay, so this now talks to the maturity of our politics.
Yes.
So when we are voting, I think we need to mature beyond voting for parties and voting for the quality of candidates. Yeah, this is so important. As you know, in the past, people have tended to vote in bloc.
Yeah.
Either you are a ZANU supporter, and so even if they put a candidate who is inappropriate, you just vote for them.
Yeah.
And the maturity of our politics must imply that I actually look more closely. What does the party represent? And in a particular constituency, do I believe they've put the best candidate available?
Yes.
And if the answer is no, vote, pick and choose, make your own omelette, so to speak.
Yes.
Create your own... Yeah.
Yeah.
Choose and pick and choose. I vote a councillor who I know has got capacity.
Yes.
I vote for an MP who I believe to have capacity.
Yes.
And I vote for a head of state who I genuinely believe to have capacity.
Absolutely.
Then we'll have arrived.
Absolutely. I know. I gotta let you go. But I'm so into what you're saying right now. So the last thing that I'm gonna ask you, the environment. We are in a new dispensation.
Yeah.
What are your thoughts?
So far, and I've traveled through the country quite a bit, so far you can see that it's like a bottled system. The pressure cooker, the pressure is being released gently,
yes.
but people are still cautious.
Yes.
Is this genuine?
Yes.
Is it going to stay?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, people
yes.
are kind of feeling their way.
Yes.
But if this persists, then it will be very good for our country. But I think it's still early stages for us to celebrate.
Thank you so much.
Thank you and thanks.
You're welcome. So anyway, that was Dr. Kosana Moyo, and giving you your thoughts, and like we kept saying, you know, this is what it is. It's a competition. It's a challenge. It's a challenge to anyone, not directly just MDC or anything like that. It's a challenge to anybody. So let's challenge this system. Why not challenge this system? Let's challenge the system. I'm all for it. I'm excited to see challenges everywhere. I don't know why we should not challenge people. Hey, how are you?
Good.
Great. Hey, look who is here.
Hi, everyone. How are you?
Asha. What do you have to say to people? This is Povo.
Oh,
the
yeah.
Political party?
No. Nope. It's not a political party.
What is it?
Povo is a coalition of independent candidates. Just people who are free thinking, people who do not not fit into a political setting, political party setting. We've just come together. Some of these guys had already started their campaign as independent. So we just said, guys, let's put resources together. Let's come together. Let's work together. That's basically what POPO is.
Okay.
It's not a political party.
So if I am ZANU-PF or I'm MDC, why should I vote for an independent candidate?
Okay. That's a difficult one, I'll admit. But what we are saying is that for the past 38 years, right, particularly Harare has been in the hands of ZANU-PF and currently MDC, and we know what Harare is like today. So people can vote for whoever they want for president, for MP, but we're just saying for Harare, for this city, try us. You know, try us, and there is an issue. It's not like there's no issue. There is an issue with Harare. Yeah. So we're saying let's fix our city, let's fix our capital city.
Okay.
That's what we're saying.
We'll talk some more.
All right.
All right.
What up, everyone? We're here with Savannah Madabambe. What up, what up? So we both on live. It's a beautiful day.
But hi there, how is everybody?
We managed to get Savannah all the way from New York City.
Oh, Zipa, we have been here for months.
Have you been here for months?
Yeah, I've been here since January.
I didn't know. Savannah didn't meet out anybody. How you been though?
I'm doing good.
Fantastic.
So, what's all this about? Can you explain to the people what POVO is all about?
Well, POVO is a coalition of young independents who've come together to run for the Harare Council. Because the Harare Council currently is inept. It's run by old, tired human beings who must go home and rest. We need the young people to step up. Thank you, Pastor Mawarire, Rasta Marshall, Henry Mlangatire, the whole team of POVO. We're proud of you guys. We're running for MP. They're running for council. Two of them are in our constituency. So we're really happy to come here and listen to their ideas. They're not going to get our cosign immediately.
Yes.
They have to buy us with good, solid ideas so that we know that they can run the city for our children.
Yes.
Thank you, Savannah.
You're welcome.
We're very happy to be here.
I am excited. For me, I'm not a politician, but why I'm here, I want to make a challenge. I want the politics of
all
people. Challenge. What
do you mean
challenge?
Challenge.
New ideas.
New challenge.
Exciting, exciting. I'm going to find someone. Guess who is here for you guys?
My sister.
You know,
I'm so sorry that I couldn't come.
No, it's all right.
Here we live.
Here we are. So
please, hey, thank you so much for joining us. Thank you, Savannah, for coming. This lady and me go all the way back to a demo in New York.
Which you got arrested for. Because supposedly you planned that demo.
Exactly. Aba demo era iplana na vanhu vakawanda vari kuAmerica. You know what? That is nothing compared to what we're about to see in our country.
Okay. So, you know, a lot of people want to know what POVO is all about. What is this political party? Are you trying to be another presidential candidate?
Well, I mean, first of all, you know, people's own voice, which we call POVO, is not running for president. These are independent candidates for council. Isuzu Basarelu Dere Service Delivery. Our cities can be better. The problem sometimes is that people think Kutizo can only cancel a council. No, councillors actually have a lot of work and a big mandate to do Kutibatsirane on the ground. When you look at Harare, you've been driving around.
No, now we avoid
our
Kutendem
city. We're going to go to Maputo,
China.
Then Vura. We can, once you know what, it only takes a few people who are committed to organize that. So I think that's what we want to do, to provide an alternative for the residents of Harare and hopefully Kanashkanzoshanda for the rest of the cities. Could you guys very committed? Now look, it's just that spreads out kuti tip hands in the one who would divide the vote.
You know, that's what people are saying.
Name.
Direct challenge to the MDC. What do you have to say about that?
Because
you are challenging MDC.
Yes, no, you see, we're not challenging MDC. This is where people get it wrong. We're not challenging MDC. We are challenging poor service delivery. We're challenging the lack of development. the MDC is welcome to compete.
Yes.
As much as other people are welcome to compete.
Let me ask you a question.
Van, in fact, the MDC and the MDC Alliance, we and personally I have supported them and still support them still.
Yes.
And you do.
Now, the biggest question I'm getting from people is that they feel you are betraying them. They are your voice. Listen, your voice is a voice of thousands. And now if you transition from being a councilman, being an activist into a councilman, there's going to be a huge void. That's what they feel.
I think the fortunate thing about council is that council allows us, you're close enough to the ground to continue being a community organizer. We don't lose the voice. I'm surprised, I think, you know, Savanaga, the voice was never supposed to be the Munu one. Manuvesing at ite voice. Let's have more and more people take up that space. This flag is something that everyone owns and everyone should speak up for. So my job is to say, look, let us now help each other to be people that speak up, that stand up, singa achke. I'll continue. People's own voice and going for council, but that doesn't mean I've abandoned the agenda of standing up for injustices and against corruption and against poverty.
All right. Let me let you go.
Thanks, Savannah. Good. So we'll talk and it's so good to see you. Hey, guys. Thanks.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
So guys, we're trolling on Twitter. Savannah's live.
Going on. Hi guys. How are you?
She's running for MP for this constituency. How are you feeling about this?
I'm feeling good. Honestly, we have to get to a stage where we think like young people, where we get innovative, where we get outside the box.
I'm so happy that everyone is sitting on nice chairs with cloths.
Exactly.
Not on the dust,
exactly.
Man.
Exactly.
Yes.
Yes.
Why is there no sofas for the...
There's no sofas here.
I want to see the sofas.
We need to be level. We need to be equal, you know? We have to think innovative. Our political parties have failed. They failed to run the city council since 1980. At least now we've got younger brains, innovative brains, new brains bringing in new things. I think that is what we want, new people.
Right, so, you know, RS Central, Linda, our candidate, we're happy, we're excited. She came dressed in the colors of the purple team just to show solidarity.
Because they're in my constituency, what do you expect?
And then she's part of the purple campaign, so go check out Linda. I shall leave Sister Savannah to interview for a second.
All right. Hey, Linda. Savannah. So, here's the thing. Why are you here to support me?
Why am I here?
Yeah.
I support independent people. I support independent critical thinkers who are driven by their motive to change things. At least one thing that I know about this group of councillors is they are driven by their passion to develop their city. They are not driven by a passion of bootlicking a certain political party leader so as to get opportunities to loot or to be corrupt. This is why I'm so excited, because I know like half of the councillors in this forward team, and I know their capabilities. I actually believe in their able and capable leadership, and that is what we want. We have to think outside the box. We can't say because the Smith regime left a legacy of political parties, and we have to continue doing that. What's the point of going to school and being educated when you can't be innovative and come up with new ideas?
Yes.
I'm so excited about this. We need to change our mindset and do things differently.
Yeah.
And I'm so excited.
My activist ASA, they all have come in with a political agenda, an agenda to end up in politics. What do you have to say?
What is the meaning of an activist? Activist means a person who is championing or who is advocating for political, social, and economic change.
Yes.
That is the meaning of an activist.
Yes,
so an activist is political at the end of the day. People should be asking us why we are now deciding to run for office, and then we answer.
Yes.
We are now running for office because and nothing is changing. We've just been waffling at the peripheries, and people have been looking at us and laughing at us and saying, "What is of a nature?" But at least let us take that passion. For me, I'm taking that passion to parliament. I'm going to make sure that the laws of this land are aligned to the constitution so that there's no injustice. There is no point on trying to go about and nothing happens.
Yes.
Let me go there and do it. But you said you're going to change this. Why things haven't changed?
Yes.
Exactly.
And do you think that there's going to be a void left where you're coming? as an activist? You're leaving a void as an activist?
I don't think so, because what I've been doing in the past 5 years, I've also been grooming other activists.
Yes.
I am not one of those like the Changirais or the Mgabes, who used to say Chunde Changu. Because up to now, even some of these former councillors, some of them are mentored by me. That's me.
Yes.
I believe in creating second generation and third generation leaders.
Yes.
It's not about us. We have to leave something for posterity. But you cannot go to Chunde Changu, Karashiko to Chete Chete, Karakuti Wongo Imbori One. There's something wrong with you. You're a narcissist. You don't believe in generational leadership.
Narcissism.
Yes.
Yeah,
Achidi narcissism.
Yeah.
We now want to get to a stage where we collectively work together with a collective responsibility to rebuild Zimbabwe and to make Zimbabwe great again. That is what is important.
Thank you so much, Linda.
You're welcome,
let me just, I want to talk to you offline.